Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another LaunchBox news video. Today, we're going to be focusing on Android and our newly released version 1.18. Just like all of our releases, whether it's for Windows or Android, we've got fixes, improvements, and some new features. We're going to go over all the new features here, and if you want to check out the full changelog, link for that is in the description. And the first major change I want to focus on here is scope storage. So this is going to be really great for emulators that don't really support front ends on Android. One that comes to mind is the DraStic emulator. It's got its own launcher built in and an older version of LaunchBox for Android. If I was to try to launch a game, it would bring me into the emulator and I'd have to start the game from there. But now with this latest version, we've introduced scope storage. First time you start this up, you can actually choose scope storage, play. Game launch requires setting the Nintendo DS game folder path. We're going to go ahead and set the folder. Mine is in my downloads, games, Nintendo DS. We're going to use this folder. So it's going to take us directly into the emulator, as you can see. Again, in the past with an older version of LaunchBox for Android, if I was to do this, it would bring us into the emulator and we'd have to start the game from there. But with scope storage, it just makes it a lot easier for these emulators that don't natively support front ends on Android to work. So using that initial launch method to set up scope storage with emulators that require it just makes it easy for most people out there. But for advanced users, we can always go into the emulator settings and right here, scope storage permissions. We can clear access to scope storage from here. We can add a new path. So yeah, if you want to do it manually, not a problem too. And again, not all emulators are going to require scope storage, but there are a few here and there for Android. The first one that came to mind to me was the DraStic emulator. But yeah, this is going to make life so much simpler getting LaunchBox set up with emulators that don't natively support front ends on Android. And of course, we're always trying to expand the compatibility of LaunchBox on Android. So with this release, we've added new platforms, emulators, and cores, like Nintendo 64DD, Sega Pico, Mega Duck, BBC Microcomputer System, VC4000, and ScumVM. And as for new emulators, Citron, Droid Arcadia, and Infinity P8 Player are fully compatible now with LaunchBox on Android. Plus, for RetroArch, the Dirk Simple Core is now compatible. And if you're not familiar with this, this is a very simple FMV Laserdisc game player. It uses the original footage, but it doesn't use the original ROMs. The game logic has been implemented from scratch in Lua. It's very simple to use if you want to play something like Dragon's Lair. Another new feature we implemented with this release of LaunchBox for Android is a built-in orientation lock. In the past, we actually had to rely on Android's orientation lock, but now from options, if we scroll down a bit here, we've got a new section for orientation lock. And we've got four different options: portrait, landscape, reverse portrait, reverse landscape. So with this here, we can set it directly from within LaunchBox on Android and have our correct orientation set up at any time with this application. And like I mentioned, just like all of our releases, we've got other fixes and improvements. If you're interested in checking out the full changelog, I'll leave a link in the description. But that's going to wrap it up for this one. Definitely check out the forum because we've always got more stuff coming up over there. And like always, thanks for watching.